Hello and welcome to the channel. Now it's time to test DC to DC converter within full assembly of the inverter. Let's see how I got on. Now I've assembled inverter. I've connected the link between plus and plus here. So effectively this will allow us to deliver the high voltage that goes into the DC to DC converter, and then it comes into the inverter there. And now we see the setup on the opposite side, so that's where the high voltage comes in, minus and plus. And at the same time I have connected the little battery that will be charged by DC to DC converter. So this is positive, as you can see it's isolated from the ground, and this is negative. Okay, let's start and see if we can turn this on. I'm powering my setup from the same battery. This is about 100 volts battery. This is the fuse, and we use this low voltage power supply to supply 12 volts. Now I have my box, so this is the positive, comes inside here. So this is the cable that electronically controls the open inverter board, and this is our switches that this will turn on ignition equivalent, and this is start. Okay, so well, I'll start from turning the high voltage on. The power supply is on and on like this. Now this will start open inverter board, and now we're doing pre-charge. So this opened the main contactor and finished the pre-charge cycle. So now we're charging our battery. Current coming into the battery is 7.5 amps. One of the issues I've encountered is that DC to DC converter overshoots when it's turned off. And I think the reason for this is because the sense signal here connected through the 0 ohm resistor to the 12 volts supply on the Damien's board design. Effectively, this is the DC to DC sense signal that is connected to the power supply. So when you turn it off, the DC to DC converter sensing that the voltage is very low and it's trying to increase it. And I think DC to DC sense signal should really be connected to the battery that you are charging. I think what I'm planning to do is to connect DC to DC sense signal rather than having it connected to the low voltage power supply. I want to connect it to actual battery I'm charging. And at the same time, IGCT signal is there to enable converter, so it will need 12 volts. And I want to supply the PWM signal to this pin 5, DC to DC VLO. How I'm planning to connect this? So if we look at the resistor R39, on the PCB, R39 is located very close to the switch that allows us to enable DC on off. And effectively one leg is connected to the switch. It's just a link basically, and the other leg is going through here, and effectively that comes into this pin of the JST connector here. And this truck here is IGCT signal to enable the inverter. What I think I'm going to do, I'm just going to desolder this R39 resistor, which will disconnect it from here, and then I will have a link going from R39. I will connect this link to one of these spare legs. Not sure which one, maybe this one. Yeah, there's a spare leg on this connector here. As far as VLO signal goes, it comes in into this potential divider and gets into the link connection 5. So what I want to do, I want to get it hooked up to the Atmega chip, and we'll probably use one of this aircon AC conditioner control pins, or maybe AC pre-charge control. Just need to find out which one will accept PWM signal. So effectively I just want to connect it here and do a link for the PWM connection on the VLO signal. First I needed to unsolder the 0 ohm resistor, and I use the technique where I cover both ends of it with solder so I can remove the resistor, just flip it off from its position. And now I could solder in the wire to get our DC to DC sense signal into IDC connector, and then consequently out into the sensing position. Although I think now that I have to fit it in within inside of the inverter and get it connected to the actual battery connection part on the DC to DC converter.